Dear friends, welcome to another video. This is Nick from educate.tv and today we are going to build this easy but very useful Arduino project. We are going to develop a digital voltmeter. Without any further delay, let's get started. In this video, we are going to build this digital voltmeter, a very easy to build project, but very useful as well. With this project, we can measure the voltage of our voltage sources or monitor the battery level of our projects. Let's see the project in action. I have connected two wires to the voltage sensor module I'm using today. I place the red wire to the positive terminal of an AA battery and the black wire to the negative terminal of the battery. In the display, we get its voltage. Let's now try this 18650 battery. We get 3.5 volts. Let's now measure this big 12-volt battery. The voltage is 12.1 volts. If we compare the readings with a multimeter, we can see that the measurements are really close. The project is working fine. But be careful, the maximum input voltage that this sensor can measure is 25 volts. So, if you exceed it, you are going to burn your Arduino pin. Let's now see how to build this project. The parts needed in order to build this project are these: an Arduino Uno or any other Arduino board with 5V logic levels, a voltage sensor, a Nokia 5110 LCD display, a breadboard and some wires. The cost of the project is very low, it's around $10. You can find links for all the parts in the description of the video. The connection with Arduino is very easy. We only have to connect two wires to Arduino. The pin with the minus sign goes to Arduino ground and the signal pin, which is marked with an S, goes to any analog pin of Arduino. I am using analog pin 0 today. That's it. We can leave the positive pin unconnected since it is not used at all by the module. Next, we have to connect the Nokia 5110 LCD display. Please watch the detailed tutorial I have prepared on how to use the Nokia 5110 LCD display. That's it, if we now power up the project, in the display, a splash screen is displayed for a couple of seconds and after that, we are ready to measure the voltage. But now, let's see how this sensor module works. This voltage sensor is very simple, it consists of only two resistors. You can build your own easily if you wish, or you can buy this module sensor with less than a dollar if you want something already built. This is how it works. This sensor is actually a voltage divider. A voltage divider circuit is a very common circuit that takes a higher voltage and converts it to a lower one by using a pair of resistors. The formula for calculating the output voltage is based on Ohm's law and it is the following. In this module, the R1 is 30,000 ohms and the R2 is 5,500 ohms. If we put 25 volts at the input and make the calculations, we get 5 volts at the output. And that's the maximum voltage an analog pin of Arduino can handle. So, if we exceed 25 volts at the input, we will burn the analog pin of Arduino. The Arduino Uno has a 10-bit analog-to-digital converter, so the resolution that we can achieve using this sensor is 25 millivolts. If we use an Arduino Due, we can achieve even better resolution since it has a 12-bit analog-to-digital converter. But of course, we need to build our own voltage sensor because the Arduino Due board uses 3.3V logic levels and any voltage beyond that will destroy its analog pin. Let's now see the software side of the project. As you can see, the code of this project is extremely easy. All we need is a library for the display and a few lines of code. All we do is to read the value from the analog pin 0, make some calculations based on the formula we saw earlier, and then we display the result on the screen. As always, you can find the code of the project in a link in the description of the video. As you can see, we can easily build our own voltmeter using an Arduino and a simple sensor that we can easily build by ourselves. It is a very easy project to build and, in my opinion, a very interesting one. Except from useful, this project is also very educational. One can learn a lot from a project like this, from voltage dividers to analog to digital converters. It's a great learning experience. I hope that you liked it. If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post videos about do-it-yourself projects every Saturday. I love making things and I believe that anyone can make things. Anyone can become a maker. That's why I created this channel, in order to share my knowledge with the community and learn from the community. I hope you will join us. Until next Saturday, watch, learn, build.